Okay, so let's look at question 11. In an audit of an inventory application, which approach will provide the best evidence that purchase orders are valid? A, testing whether inappropriate personnel can change application parameters. B, tracing purchase orders to a computer listing. C, comparing receiving reports to purchase orders details. Then D, reviewing the application documentation. Of course, the application documentation will not give you evidence that purchase orders are valid. Okay, comparing reports to purchase order details, that too will not give you the information. Tracing purchase order to a computer listing. The best answer is to test whether somebody can actually modify the system without the authority. Okay, so that means that person can generate illegal purchase order. So the answer is A. Okay, the extent to which data will be collected during an IS audit should be determined based on the A, availability of critical and required information, auditor's familiarity with the circumstances, auditor's ability to find relevant evidence, D, purpose and scope of the audit being done. Of course, as we have said, the audit in all will be determined by the purpose, the objective of the audit. All right, why are we initiating the audit to determine the extent of evidence we are going to gather? So the answer is D. The responsibility, authority and accountability of the IS audit function is appropriately documented in an audit, of course you should know that charter must be approved by the IS level of management, approved by the audit department and management. Of course, audit department cannot approve the audit charter. Approved by user department management, that is incorrect. Change every year. Of course, audit charter is more or less a stable document. So the answer is approved by the highest level of management. A. All right, an IS auditor discover evidence of fraud perpetrated with a manager's user ID. The manager has written the password allocated by the system administrator, that is the default password, inside his or her desk drawer. All right, the IS auditor should conclude that the manager assistant perpetrated the fraud. How do you verify that? No. Perpetrator cannot be established beyond doubt. Of course, most likely this will be correct, but let's check other option. Fraud must have been perpetrated by the manager. There is no evidence since he kept the password in his right. Anybody could have seen it. System administration perpetrated the fraud. There is no evidence. There is no way you can prove that. So the answer, the best answer is B. Perpetrator cannot be established beyond doubt. 15. During a review of customer master file, an IS auditor discovered numerous customer name duplications arising from variations in customer's first name. Alright, to determine the extent of the duplication, the IS auditor will use these cards. Test data to validate data input. No, test data cannot be used because the problem now is that you have a table, a master file, where you have a customer name. Alright, being duplicated because you now have customer with bearing John aplenty, alright, in that table. So it's creating confusion. Can you use test data to solve that? No. Test data to determine system source capability? No. Generalize all the software to search for address field duplications. Generalize all the software to search for account field duplication. The best answer is C. Remember, we said that the problem is that first name is common, all right, in the database. Even first name is common, address cannot be the same. All of them will have different addresses. So you can use address. If name is a problem, you cannot use name to sort. You can use address field to sort using a JAS, like an audit command language. All right, an IS auditor should use statistical sampling and not judgments or non-statistical sampling when probability of error must be objectively quantified. The auditor wishes to avoid sampling risk. Alright, you cannot avoid sampling risk if you do sampling. The only way to avoid sampling risk is to use 100% of the population. Alright, use generalized audit software is when generalized audit software is unavailable. When the tolerable error rate cannot be determined, the answer is A. Use statistical sampling when you must have objective quantification. Alright, 17. During a security audit of IT processes, an IS auditor found that there will be no documented security procedure. There were no documented security procedures. The auditor should create the procedures document. Wow, illegal. IS auditor is not allowed to do such. Alright, terminate the audit. No. Conduct compliance testing. When there already there is, you can't even find the security procedures documented. This D is the answer: identify and evaluate existing practices. Sometimes there may be no documentation. All right, you will learn more in domain 2 capability maturity model. All right, the first level is initial or ad hoc, where everybody just doing anything he likes. Second level is repeatable, where there is a way of doing things but it is not documented. The third level, which is higher than the second level, is the defined level, where there is effective documentation. So it is possible the organization could be at repeatable level. They don't have documented procedures, but they have a way of doing things. So if there is no documented procedures, the next thing is to say, okay, how do you do it? How do you handle this kind of situation in the organization? So if the answer is D. When implementing continuous monitoring system, an analysis does is to identify reasonable target threshold, high risk areas within the organization, location and format of output files, application that provide the highest potential payback. Of course, the answer is B. Always focus on the areas of highest risk. Number 19, in an IS audit of several critical servers, the IS auditor wants to analyze audit trails to discover potential anomalies, unusual behavior in user or system behavior. All right, which of the following tools is most suitable for performing that task? Case tools. You learn more about case tools in domain 3. Case tools are used for system development, so it will not work here. Embedded data collection tools. Well, you can use that also in the online environment to gather exemptions. Heuristic scanning tools. You can use that one for as tools for antivirus. All right, trend or variance detection tool. This will be the best. All right, because they can monitor trend. So when the trend changes from normal to abnormal, they will pick it. So the best answer is Z. All right, the key element in a risk analysis is what? Audit planning, controls, vulnerability, liability. All right, this is a very, very tricky question. Is the issue is between control and vulnerability. I will go for C, vulnerability, because before you can talk about control, you must first talk about vulnerability. In fact, risk analysis starts from vulnerability. You do inventory of the asset. From inventory of the asset, you start identifying the vulnerability of the asset before you now start thinking of the threats that can exploit that vulnerability. So the answer here is C.